very glory and try to diminish his
legacy.
His writing credit for that particular song. But he wrote a bunch of songs.
Well, let's check it out, man.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hello, guys and gals. It's me, Mojo Daddy Mystic, back with my main man, Uncle Ted, and we're back. Like I said, we was on hiatus.
Yeah.
A sabbatical.
Yeah, rolling in slow for 2023.
Yeah, we take it easy.
Yeah.
So we're back and back in action and good to see you all. Hope you all are having a blessed new year so far.
Yes,
so good.
Yes.
You know, staying above ground.
Yeah.
And we're going to get back into it with Barrett Strong.
Yes.
Now, this is a Motown cat.
Uncle
Ted, can you...
Well, he was one of the greatest songwriters that Motown ever produced. Yeah. He co-wrote a lot of songs.
A lot of songs for artists like Gladys Knight.
Gladys Knight, Temptations. Yeah.
So he was kind of like the Carole King of Motown.
Well, I ain't gonna call him Carole King.
Oh no! I mean, in terms of writing the lyrics. You know, as a songwriter, not the same style. It's two different worlds.
Yeah.
I'm just saying
they're polar opposites, but they both make it sweet.
As songwriters, they would give it to other artists.
Yes.
You know, but the credit never really. Came back, or it took a while for the credit to come back to the person. Well, that's what I mean.
Yeah, and his publisher, like he said, the money is in retaining your publishing rights.
Music publishing.
Yes. When you retain your publishing rights, you continuously get paid.
Right.
Yes.
Right. No matter how long it is, that money still keeps coming in.
You know, like Whitney Houston made Dolly Parton a whole bunch of money.
I know she did. Yeah, off of that. Off of that one song.
Always love you. Every time Whitney sang it, Dolly said, cha-ching.
Cha-ching.
She said, I love the way she interpreted my song.
Cha-ching.
Yeah, we both get paid. Oh, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah.
All right. So let's get into it, man. Right. What song are we going to do?
Huh?
What song are we going to do?
Money.
Okay, money. All right.
But you know what they say about money, right?
What are they?
Reverend Ike said, money is not the root of all evil. It's the lack of it.
Money changes everything,
man. Reverend Ike.
We all need it, man.
Yeah.
That's a great quote.
Yes, man. Sir. Reverend Ike.
Yeah. Reverend Ike Turner?
No, not Ike Turner. This is Ike the preacher out of New York.
Oh,
he had a church, man.
Oh, all right.
Yeah. You know what he said?
What did he say, man? Oh, he's a street preacher.
Oh, no. He had a church, man. Reverend Ike had a church, and he was on television, man.
Oh, he was actual.
People tuning on Sunday nights.
He was actual televangelist?
Yeah, he was the godfather of T.D. Jakes in there, man.
Oh, wow.
He preached prosperity.
Okay.
Yeah, he said, money is not the root of all evil, it's the lack of it.
Wow.
And you know what else he said? One Sunday morning, I heard him say.
What'd he say?
He said, the white man work is mad, black man work is behind. Which one you think he worked the longest, man?
Behind.
I said that one Sunday morning.
The white man work is behind. Which one do you think works the longest?
Oh,
that's
Reverend
going back to the plantation days.
No, but Reverend Ike was brilliant.
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
Is he still on TV?
No, sir. Reverend Ike is an ancestor.
Oh, man. He passed away.
But he preached about empowerment.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Well, that's fantastic, man. We can all use it, man.
Yeah, Reverend Ike, man. Well, people my age, I'm about 70 years old. People my generation know about Reverend Ike. Yeah.
You're 70 years young?
Well, almost 70,
almost, man.
Yeah, almost. I'm 2 years away. Yeah. Hey. Hopefully, I make it. Yeah.
You gonna make it, man?
Yeah.
I thought you was 19.
No, sir. I wish I was.
One man work is mine, and the black man work is mine.
Which one you worked the longest?
Dang.
And that was Reverend Ike, man. And I was like 17 in the projects when I heard him preach that.
Well.
And my parents would sit there and watch Reverend Ike. Yeah. We didn't follow him, but that was a source of inspiration. He and Adam Clayton Powell, right?
It's an inspiring quote.
Yes, empowerment.
Empowerment quote.
Yeah.
So let's get into this music, man. Motown.
Yeah.
And let's do it, man.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Writers out of Motown.
Motown's own.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh man.
Yeah, that's a powerful song.
What an artist, man.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Great voice. Too.
Yes, sir. Yes,
so that
sir.
Was going on in the
60s.
In the house parties.
Your house parties, you know. Duke joints, you know.
Sure.
Your fish fry, you know, that's a get up and get down song.
Cookout song.
Yeah, cookout, cook up, whatever, yeah.
So we're giving him his props on this channel, guys. Yeah. Barrett Strong. A product of Motown. Yeah. Yeah, just the legendary label.
What a great house writer. Yeah.
Yes. A house writer. There
great
we go.
House writer.
That's what I'm talking about.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So what are your guys' thoughts on Barrett Strong? Money.
Money.
Iconic song that's been sampled.
Yes.
A number of times.
Yes,
you know, by a lot of artists.
I'm sure the rappers would heard this song.
Oh, yeah.
They talk about it. Money.
Yeah, they can't get enough of it.
Yes.
So let us know your thoughts on Barrett Strong, and we'll see you on the next one. My man.
Okay.
All right, we're getting back in the swing.
Yeah.